Oh boy, it's oh hi everybody. Hey, it's Sunday. It's May the 7th. I'm Pastor David, and well, I've been listening to voices. In fact, I wonder if you can pick these out. You'll recognize this one from, well, at least from my childhood. Take a listen.
I knew I should have taken that lift train to Albuquerque.
Yep. That's right. You know the voice. You know Bugs Bunny when you hear him. Well, how about this one? This one comes from a little before my time.
So first of all, let me assert my firm belief that the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Sure enough, that's the president himself. That's FDR back in the day. Well, let me have you listen to one that's a little closer to home. See if you recognize her.
Hello, everyone. I'm glad that you appreciate the sound of my voice. But do you know my name?
Yep, that's right. There she is. There she is, jacking up. Okay, this one, well, I'll tell you, this is the voice of the person that, well, every pastor wants to sound like this.
Hello, everybody. Can you hear my voice? Do you know my name?
Of course. This is Ed Kuhn. You got it. You got it. Well, let me have you listen to this one.
Hello, everyone. This is the sound of my voice. Do you know who I am?
That's right. That's none other than Ashley Engler. She runs our preschool. Okay, we got one more. This might be the toughest of all, but this is also the coolest of all.
Hi, everyone. I'm glad to share the sound of my voice. Do you know my name?
You got it! This is Brady. Brady Zabel, the best. Well, I've been listening to voices. You've been listening to voices. Jesus said, I'm the good shepherd, and my sheep, what? Hear my voice. Have you heard that voice? Let's go to church.
Thank you. Hi, it's Pastor Deb, and I'm wearing my special stole today, the one with all the children that I wear for baptisms. Four baptisms today. Lots of little ones who hear the voice of the Good Shepherd. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. O God, our Good Shepherd, you know your sheep by name and lead us to life through the valleys of death. Help us to hear and follow your voice, that we may walk with courage where you lead. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over.
Now a reading from John's Gospel. Jesus said, "The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. And when he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers." Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly, I tell you, I am the gate of the sheep. All who come before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved and will come in and go out and find pasture. And the thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. And I came that they may have life and have it abundantly."
Hi guys, it's Miss Kendall. Today we're going to talk about sometimes hearing voices and what that means. So, can we hear a mysterious voice?
Hello, do you know who this is?
Camden?
Me!
No, who do we think that is? Who is him?
Pastor David!
Pastor David!
All right.
So sometimes God speaks to us when we can't always recognize his voice, right? Like Ashley teaches all of our teachers how to teach you. And God speaks through her. Isn't that so cool? Yes.
So, how'd you do on the big quiz? Did you get Bugs Bunny? Did you get Jackie Knopp? Did you get Brady? We thought about downloading ChatGPT. It's the artificial intelligence, one that's intended to simulate human conversation. But it seemed way too creepy to download something like that into the church's computers. You remember Jesus, this good shepherd. He says he calls his own sheep by name and he leads them out. And when he has brought out all of his own, he goes ahead of them and the sheep follow him. Why? Because they know his voice. In a world of misinformation, echo chambers, in a world of mock rage and performative malice, there's a lot at stake. You know, like I do. Even as we see all of these talking heads in these huge corporations all kind of change around some, it makes you wonder who speaks for who? Who has the power of the microphone? Jesus calls his own sheep by name, and he leads them out, and when he has brought them out, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him. Why? Because they know his voice. Now, most of us, I think if we're being completely honest, tend to gravitate toward those voices that we like. Well, not just the quality and character of the sound of a voice, but you know what's behind the voice? You know what I mean. One that seems familiar, one that seems to resonate with our own perceptions and our own experiences. Who's that for you? You know, it might be a columnist. It might be a preacher or an entertainer, might be a teacher or some news personality. In this wider culture of ours, there's so much at stake. Political power, advertising revenue, and market share, and all of it driven by this peculiarly human capacity to get attached to a voice. Now, voices that corroborate our worldview, voices that validate our perspective, or seem to reinforce the interpretation that we have for why things are the way they are, we like that. And when another voice comes along that might challenge that, when another voice comes along that might provide some exception to whatever it is we think is the case, what? We just want to switch. But sometimes, though, the voices, well, we want to ban them. Ban the book, or outlaw the curriculum, or even make it a crime to call a thing what it is. He calls his own sheep by name, and he leads them out. And when he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him. Why? Because they know his voice. But beware. You know, this shepherd, this voice, this narrative is going to mess with you. It's going to change things. Because after all, listening carefully to this one will expose us. We'll reveal our priorities and our biases. This voice, this voice is going to hand to us our fears and our longings and change them all around. Because this shepherd is not just looking for nice sheep. This shepherd is not after polite sheep or sheep that just sort of go with the flow. It's going to mean more than that. This shepherd is creating and sustaining honesty. In fact, enough integrity that it won't let a bully or a gaslighter get away with it. No, this shepherd is creating and sustaining something bigger than that. Looking for fearlessness. Courage to be compassionate, to take risks, to make sacrifices for the sake of justice, for the sake of the neighbor. Oh yeah, this is some different kind of shepherd. Because this voice is creating and sustaining something bigger, creating grace. One that accepts me just exactly as I am. Because this shepherd calls him by name and leads them out. And when he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him. Why? Oh yeah, because they know his voice. I think back to my Aunt Beverly, my mother's younger sister. And I can remember her as a young teenager, but I also remember very well when she died. She had a very, very hard life, one that was formed and shaped by a difficult addiction to alcohol. And when she died of acute liver failure, it fell to my mother to make all those arrangements, all those plans for her younger sis. And I suppose at the funeral home, they must have handed her a catalog that, you know, had all of the options for caskets and cremation, all the different kinds of flowers she would get or what it was that she might be wearing. And I don't really remember what my mom decided about those things. What I do remember is my mom's decision about the headstone, because I still see it almost every year. On that is her name. First, middle, and last. And on that little stone, of course, is the year of her birth and the year of her death. But then off to one side, there's a Jesus. Now, I admit, it's a Jesus that looks straight out of a 1950s Sunday school book, because this is a Jesus that looks blonde and totally Caucasian. But what catches my eye is that this Jesus, with one hand, has a shepherd's staff, but in the other, a little lamb. I think that little lamb is my Aunt Beverly. He calls his own sheep by name, and he leads them out. And when he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him. Why? Because they know his voice. My Aunt Beverly knew that voice. I think I know that voice, because that voice knows me. Amen.
Pray, knowing our voices are heard by the Good Shepherd. We pray for all those who are discerning the call to leadership in this congregation. Good Shepherd, help them hear your voice and follow where you lead. Bless the yes of those who answer this call and the holy no of those listening for a different way to serve. We trust that you hold the future in your hands. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for Patty, Suzanne, Kevin, Debbie, Becky, Gary, Andrea, Jay, Al, Ralph, and Jan. We pray for our young lambs, Gracie, Tyler James, Tristan, Holly, and Vivian. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the newly baptized, for Emma Jean, Natalie, Madeline, and Daniel and Scotty. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for Anya and Garth and their family on the death of Anya's mother, Judy. We pray for the victims of shootings, mass shootings. Do not let our ears become accustomed to the sound of gunshots and the cries of those who grieve their dead. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We know you hear our voice when we pray silently or loud for all those we place in your care. And for the good shepherd who leads us from death to life, we give you thanks. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Peace be with you.
You know, it's so good to be together for worship. And whether that means in person in this place or via the electron waves, it's all good. And we cherish it all because we cherish you. Maybe it's time for the news. Have you been counting sheep? Well, I think about that not just to fall asleep, but counting sheep because they all matter. In fact, if we can come and connect with you and share home Holy Communion, why don't you email us here at the address that it's appearing there at the bottom of the screen. The Commons is full of art, full of flower art, and spring has sprung. It may be that God has been bugging you about leadership in the life of the congregation. The nominating committee is doing its work. Let them know what you think. Outside at Our Savior's, 2024 is cycling up. In fact, today at 11 a.m., there's a forum. They're going to share some of the ideas that are in the works, but they also want to hear from you. So why don't you participate? Family and Friends Gathering is tonight, and I'm trying to remember, what is it? They're doing something. What's going on there?
Trivia quiz and game night.
Cool.
And Cinco de Mayo food.
That's a lot for one big night. Well, we love it all. You know what? We're counting mortarboards, and if there are any mortarboards in your life, maybe there's a graduate you want to help us celebrate. Would you let us know? Family camp this summer is coming up, and it's guess where? It's at Camp Casey. Well, listen, gratitude is powerful, changes us, changes everything. So we thank you for your part in our work together.